نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فقد قال سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وقال أيضا في آية أخرى ومن يطع الله ورسوله فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا الحمد لله to the honorable chief guest of this function our Sarkar family members our religious scholars and our Sarkar Muridins who are gathered here from long distance my dear lovable brothers and sisters I wish to convey my hearty salam to one and all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
My dear lovable brothers and sisters, Allah created us and He made us His believers. And He gave an opportunity to be a person in Ummah of Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are all believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To get the complete and true Iman is in the hands of us. Our beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described that method in his narration. Hazrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وبلده والناس أجمعين. None of you can be a true believer of Allah till I will be more affectionable to him than his parents and his offsprings and the whole mankind. Allah said in another ayat, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. Surely the Prophet has a greater claim over the believers. My dear lovable brothers and sisters, from this ayat and hadith, we have come to know that how much of love of Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam we must have upon in our hearts. My dear lovable brothers and sisters, Allah says in another verses, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. He who obeys Allah and the Messenger, such shall be with those whom Allah has favored, the prophets, those steadfast in truthfulness, the matriarchs, and the righteous. How excellent will be they for companions. My dear lovable brothers and sisters, for the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there would be a reason to reveal from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with just tariffs in books of tafsir. For example, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr. This ayat revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are all know for reason for this revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the period of Bani Israel, there was an Aamir. He prayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously for 1,000 months. When Ashabu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked to our beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, we couldn't get a chance like this, Ya Rasulullah. On behalf of this ayat was revealed. That line, the ayat, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. The reason for revealing this ayat, Imam Qurtubi rahmatullahi alayhi says in his books of tafsir, the named companion named Abdullah bin Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in whose dreams Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alighted the words of Azan. He has to Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with worry and grave, Ya Rasulullah, idha mitta wa mitna kunta fi illiyin wala ahaka wala najtabi' bika, Ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, if we all die, you will be in highest status in Yemen. We couldn't be able to see you, Ya Rasulullah. On behalf of his love, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayat. By this, we are able to understand the love which Abdullah bin Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu and upon our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Qutbi rahmatullahi alayhi says, Abdullah bin Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu keep on seeing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his lifetime every day when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. He has supplication to Allah, Ya Allah, make me blind. I will more wish to see with these eyes, in which eyes I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Qurtubi rahmatullahi says after that, fa'amiya makana, he was made blind at that moment. We should notice that there are many things to see and get excited, but our companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are not attracted from that. Blindness can bring many troubles and tortures, but they are no feel and sad for that. Hearts all with fulfilled with our love of Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, then Qutubi rahmatullahi will describe another reason for this ayat, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ نَعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسَنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. Once Hazrat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Sawbah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He appeared as so lean and so sick. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked to Sawban radiallahu ta'ala anhu, what happened to you, Sawban? Answer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Rasulullah, in your love, automatically my body color would change, ya Rasulullah. If here itself I cannot be without seeing you, then what can I do in akhirat, ya Rasulullah? On behalf of this love on Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayat. Our beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam companions had more love on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than many of its Habibin, and then the clothes in it and the foods in it and their relatives and their parents. The one and only aim of companions Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this world and hereafter, the love of Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, once some people from Tabi'in came to Al-Aamiri Allahu ta'ala anhu. They have a habit of asking doubt to companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the habit of companions ask to doubts to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They ask, kullana shayyam min al-jannah ishawwikuna ilayha. Please tell us about the benefit of heaven. You should not mean as an insignificant, but it should make us eager on it. When they ask, Hazrat Al-Qa'qa'a Usriyallahu ta'ala anhu answered them with one sentence, which consists of two words. He didn't say about any foods in it. He didn't say about any clothes in it. He didn't say about any fragrance in it. He didn't say about anything, but he replied with one sentence which consists of two words. Fiha Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in heaven. We have to think, my dear lovable brothers and sisters, Tabi'in asked him the benefit of heaven, which eager them in it. But Hazrat Al-Qa'qa'a Usriyallahu ta'ala anhu answered him, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in heaven. It is the mightiest ni'amat of the heaven regarding of Hazrat Al-Qa'qa'a Usriyallahu ta'ala anhu. From this incident, we have come to know how they love Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Alawhan qadima, wa abih kullu s-samaa.